since being in the legislature, I've been on the Finance Committee. The Finance Committee is the committee that deals with all of the tax and tax policy in the General Assembly. My theory and my thought is actually we need a total revamping of our tax policy in Pennsylvania. The state budget right now, we have, depending on who you ask, between $1.5 billion to $2 billion structural deficit. And the reason why it's a structural deficit is because if we continue to go on at that rate, we will continue to have this deficit. So I think it's important for us to understand the actual importance of what we're saying. We're not necessarily talking about just this budget and why we need a minimum wage increase for this budget, or why there needs to be a tax on natural gas for this budget. We're talking about why we need to address what the future of Pennsylvania looks like with regards to our finance. We don't have enough revenue this year. We didn't have enough last year. And quite honestly, we will be in the same position next year unless we pause and have a real conversation about what we're doing with regards to the finance of our Commonwealth. As one of my colleagues said, we have cut enough. I believe we're beyond the bone. We're now talking about going into the marrow with regards to our fiscal house. So Democrat or Republican, doesn't matter. We're all going to have to address the structural issues and the financial woes of Pennsylvania. My belief is that we should do it now and stop kicking the can down the road. For the last few years, what we've seen is one-time fixes, borrowing from Peter, as my grandmama would say, to pay Paul. I never understood who Peter or Paul was. But borrowing from one pot of money to pay for another pot, that's just not the way to do government finance. We need those funds because we need to provide those dollars for our children who are in our school systems across this Commonwealth. We need those funds for pre-K, which is important. We need those funds for higher education, not just Temple and Pitt, but we also need them for the 14 universities that we actually own: Millersville, Westchester, Bloomsburg, Kutztown, places like Cheney University, and other of those 14 universities, where not only do they provide a high quality education, but they are the economic engine for their region. If they fail, the region fails. If they fail, the region fails. That's what we're talking about when we're talking about getting back to Harrisburg. It's not just about this year's budget, but it's about having a real conversation on what the future of Pennsylvania looks like. For me, I would love for us to have a real conversation about fixing the Delaware loophole. I would. I would like us to have a real conversation about looking at what an extraction tax on natural gas looks like. But I would also like to talk about what it looks like to expand that industry, because the more that it does, the more we make as a Commonwealth. But I would also like to talk about what does a real increase in the personal income tax look like while taking out our lowest earners and exempting them from paying it, but looking at the ones of us who could afford to put another $20 bill into the kitty. Right now, 1% would generate 4 billion new recurring dollars, 2 billion for the deficit, 2 million new dollars to fund education, to fund senior programs. That's what leadership is about, and that's why we need to be back in Harrisburg. Leadership takes courage, and all we're asking is that all of our legislators across Pennsylvania, Democrat or Republican, conservative or liberal, urban or rural or suburban, to have the courage that is necessary to look Pennsylvanians in the eye and say, we are going to look at our fiscal house, we will get it in order, and we will find a solution that benefits all of Pennsylvania, not just the most of us, but damn sure the least of these. Thank you.